Hi, in this video we'll be taking a look at using chords in Doubler 2. So Doubler allows a user to create chords and chord progressions based on the note that you sing and the key that you're in. And Doubler does this by associating each note with a different chord. So we can turn this feature on by the chord button here in the Play tab. So there are a number of presets available in Doubler which take care of these chord mappings for you. The most basic one is the Triads preset, which is available for all keys, and this is the one on by default when you turn the chords on. For some of the more commonly used keys, there's also some additional presets such as Pop Simple or Pop Advanced, for example, which can provide some more nuanced chord progressions. If you want to create a custom chord progression or change the voicing of the chords, we can do that over on the Chords tab. Under Chord Mapping, we can see what chord is associated with each individual note based on the current key restriction and chord preset. So we're currently in a C major scale, and I can see that if I sing a C note, I'll hear a C major. If I sing a D note, I'll hear a D minor, and so on. I can also see on the left-hand side on the pitch wheel which notes make up the current chord that's selected. I can also create custom chord mappings by swapping out individual chords at the bottom here, either by selecting one of the suggested chords or via the drop-down menu. At the bottom of the tab, there are a number of options to adjust the voicing of the chords. So the voicing will change how the chord is played and how the individual notes of the chord are spread. And there are a number of different voicing presets you can experiment with to change the sound of the chord. The voicing section also allows a user to enable or disable the root note baseline and whether the chord will follow the octave being sung. If follow is not selective, you can select which octave the chord is played at via the shift function. So if we head back to the Play tab, we can now record these chords into our DAW. So I've got Ableton set up here with the synth, and I can hit record, and we can see those chords being recorded in straight into MIDI. Ba, ba, ba. If I open up that, there's our chords that we played. Doubler also allows a user to split which MIDI channel the chords are being sent to, meaning we can separate the single note melody and the overlapping chords. And we can do that over in the MIDI Assign tab. So here we can see the MIDI channel that the triggers, pitch, and chords are being sent to. And by default, you can see the chords and pitch are both sent out to MIDI channel 1, but we can change this, so let's put the chords to output to MIDI channel 2. So back in our DAW, we've got these two channels, and I can set one to receive information for MIDI channel 1, which will be the single note melody, and I can have the second one receiving information for MIDI channel 2, which will be the chords. And I can arm both of them and record them simultaneously, but keep that MIDI information separate. So let's record something in. Bum, bum, bum. If we take a look at that MIDI information, we'll see the single note melody here and the chords that are overlapping those. So that's an overview of the chords in Doubler 2, but make sure to check out our other videos for more in-depth guides of each part of Doubler.